All right, let's see. Put the mic closer to your...
Looks like we're going on to game one.
Yeah.
Historically, Pig has done well against Jammuth, but Pig really likes to go for his rest, so I think what this set is going to hinge on his ability to land them, while otherwise Jammuth's just very good at racking up damage, and it's tough for Puff to do on-stage combos with quite the same speed.
Yeah, like that.
Yeah.
What do you think about this matchup in general? I think obviously Puff wins. Obviously it's good for Puff, but I don't think you should be playing like a certain way.
I think that Needles are really strong and you obviously have to play around Puff's crouch since that is one of her biggest tools in this matchup, for just making Sheik's end of building up damage that much harder. But it really depends. You have to play to what Puff's doing. If Puff is going air to air against you, then your bear can outrange a lot of her stuff. It's huge and it comes out pretty much instantly.
That makes sense.
Bear is also really good, but can be harder to hit with in certain situations, so.
Yeah.
You pretty much have to train yourself not to tilt Puff until Puff's basically a 100%. Solid play all around from Jammuth right now.
I do not agree with that, but I see what he was going for. I do the same thing.
Jammuth not risking doing some move before going for the grab because Puff could potentially ASDI down or DI so that it's nothing really combos.
So do you think Pig should be crouching more, or do you think Jammuth's just good at beating crouch?
I think Jammuth is showing that he knows how to deal with crouch, but Pig has to convince him that he's not going to when he is.
Yeah, you're right. Maybe falling up here in the crouch or something silly.
Something like that could work, but Puffs go for that kind of stuff all the time.
Do they? Okay. I don't watch other Puffs. I should.
Puff almost manages to just get the roll read on the rest. Pig has a solid grasp of Jammuth's movement, but he's just not able to... Mostly not able to properly position in time, but hey, you can just get a crouch F smash for the kill.
Yeah. I think you can get an up tilt.
But does he want to rest when he's this high already? At this point, it's seeming doubtful because pretty soon we're looking at jab bear. Yeah.
Yeah. That'll do. That'll do, Donkey. That'll do. That'll do, Shrek. That'll do.
Donkey.
Donkey. Who's Donkey in this situation?
Probably Puff because she kicks and Donkey's kick.
Okay. I was gonna say Jammuth. Pig Shrek.
I mean, yeah.
They're interchangeable. You know, most Sheiks don't DI down throw well, so you can just fucking follow him up, rest.
I don't think that true combo's in this matchup, though.
No, it's just a read. They just get panicked because they're not used to seeing it. But not against Mook. I'm a big fan of forward air in this matchup.
I'm a big fan of forward air for both characters, but
yeah.
Jammuth's making sure that when he comes in, he's just at the certain range where his move can hit, so that it's less likely that he's going to get punished by crouching to something or get devastated by Bonk managing to smash or grab him. And also, J-Move just like does that zoning bear that's covering if Pig jumps in, but Pig was retreating. He tries to punish him when he's already going back. Oh my gosh. J-Move just dash dance grabs for the kill.
Yeah. I think Pig's
just a little too antsy to get that KO move. In part because he knows that he doesn't get punished as hard necessarily.
Okay.
But
there we go. That's the matchup. That's the matchup. He is getting greedy, but he can do it.
Like, Pig will really just go for the death dealer, but as long as J-Move plays in a way that respects it, then it's just going to be getting Pig damage that's unnecessary.
Yeah.
But even then, it's like 10 exchanges to 1 potentially, so...
I didn't think that was that crazy.
Crowd getting really hyped for Rory.
Let's save those. Okay.
Alright, that is exactly the kind of percent J-Move wants.
The walk-ups are good.
He might have been able to still get rested off of that F-Tilt. It's still pretty early, but now it should be safe.
Oh, I thought he was gonna rest.
Something that J-Move could potentially go for, since Pig really wants his rest so much, is you can try to smash DI up on his moves that combo into it, so that Pig goes for it and potentially misses.
I think you should F smash there to save the... to not get rest punished. See... almost every Sheik DI is the down throw to the opposite side of the platform, towards the ledge.
Unfortunately, those needles were the wrong way. He could have just died for that. Okay.
Very questionable.
J-Move was not particularly close there, so I want to say that was an accident. Also, this is good from Sheik. If Buff is going to the ledge, then you can just start throwing needles. And try not to run into up tilts or crouches.
Yeah. I think dash attack's good in this matchup. If it's past, like, the 50s. Maybe high 40s. Dash attack for Puff, that is, against Sheik. Oh, nice.
Unfortunate that when someone's as rest happy, or is happy for any kind of powerful move like that, as Pig is, you can't just try to force your way onto them constantly. Because if you can do something that looks kind of like it, like wave dash in place, you might be able to bait them and then get even more damage off of the punish for them going for it again.
Makes sense. Okay.
Alright, fortunately he managed to get both hits, so now Puff's at much more extreme percent. And we'll have a much harder time crouch canceling some of his stronger moves. J-Move just respecting the space and letting him... I mean, he's gonna let him have ledge. He's got plenty of room to work with as soon as he gets him off stage.
Yeah, oh my gosh. Look at that.
Shy Guy's coming in for the clutch.
I think Pig should be throwing in some pairs. Honestly.
I think maybe some rising pairs could help deal with certain fair zonings and some fair zoning spacings that J-Move's doing, but
I was thinking about fairs coming down on top of J-Move's areas.
I mean, that could also be a thing, but I think that, like, right there, if Jake was facing the other way, it would be much easier to hit J-Move with a rising fair than pretty much any other aerial and keep him off for some free damage and unstale all of his other moves.
That makes sense.
Because...
okay.
If there's a move buff that you really just do for the hitbox, good reaction, well, reaction from J-Move.
That'll do, Donkey.
If there's a good move buffs that you really just want to do use to get some damage with each hit, then it's probably forward air, because back air at least compensated itself pretty well. Well,
that was just the cheesiest thing, but it worked. Yeah, that makes sense though. I'd want to. Looking at it from a buff player's perspective, aka me, does seem like it's that.
But hey, even down tilt can be okay there, because you're still having a little bit of ball that reaches pretty far in front of you. Like, buff down tilt's deceptively big, even if it's really weak.
I know. I need to use it more, actually. People just convince me that it's not good, but it's good in certain situations, so you can't discount those situations. Oh, he didn't do it that time, but...
it was very close to being arrested.
Yeah.
That could have been huge for this
game. See, I feel like you should, if you get down-throwed by buff, I feel like you should, DI down and away, and then, like, buffer roll the opposite direction. Like almost every time, unless they're gonna. Nah. J-Move can look pretty dominant.
I don't think those needles necessarily covered anything that would have been reasonable to expect them to do there. They can afford to just throw moves out like that just because of how different the single hit disparity in this matchup is huge in Buff's favor, but she gets plenty of tools to make sure that she could get more hits, assuming she's in the right place to stage.
I can't hear you that well. I can hear you faintly. No, I can't.
My mic will never be in the ideal spot. Ooh. That
what do you,
should be it if it just grabs.
What do you think about up smash for Puff in this matchup? I think it's alright. Fast. Definitely can get punished very easily, but...
Puff's up smash is kind of crazy. It's just a frame slower than Fox's, which would be the same speed as grab, but it reaches behind her like immediately and knocks down pretty early. It's just a good hitbox to be able to put out.
Yeah. I like to do stuff like up smash, like grab or something crazy, or up smash pivot grab.
Pick up the time to wait a little so that you can get that bear lower, but...
There you go, okay.
I guess he really wanted to potentially hit J-Mook out of midair, but...
That's a good rest. Let's see if J-Mook can clean up this.
I was hoping for a roll right there.
Okay. Let's see. Okay.
He's not dash or jump very far forward after the down tilt.
Alright. That's GG's.